It's only a state like himself, the doors will be upon by his presence and kingdom power. It is therefore not to be intervention unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy state, these two persons come out of your arm. If anyone can show just cause that they should not walk with one together, let them speak now or else ever hereafter hold their peace. I require and charge you both as you stand in the presence of God, before whom the secret of all hearts is closed, that having duly considered the holy covenant that you are about to make, that you declare your faith each to the other. I'll be well assured of these solemn vows, kept the Bible, as God's holy word commands. That if you steadfast in them to do the will of your heavenly Father, God will bless your marriage, grant you fulfillment in it, and will establish your home in peace. Kevin, will you have this woman be your wife, live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her? In sickness and health, forsaking all others, keeping yourself holy under her, more than all should.
I will.
Andy, will you have this man be your wedded husband? Live together in the holy state of matrimony. Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him? In sickness and health, forsaking all others, keeping yourself holy under him. Let's read a portion of scripture in 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter. Familiar words, especially fitting for this occasion. If I speak with the tongue of men and of angels, but have not love, I'm a noisy gong and a clanging cymbal. If I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith, such as the moon mountains, and have not love, I'm nothing. If I give away all that I have, if I deliver up my body to be burned, and have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist upon its own way. It is not irritable. Does not rejoice with wrong, but rejoices with the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecies, they will pass away. As for tongues, they shall cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophecy is imperfect. For when the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child, but when I became a man, I gave up childish ways. But now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall understand fully, even as I am understood. So faith, hope, and love abide in these three, but the greatest of these is love. What then is this woman to be married to this man,
whether or not?
I, Kevin, take thee, Amy, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. According to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge my faith.
I, Amy, take you, Kevin, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge my faith.
Just a word of personal privilege and a word of meditation. I want to remind something rare and beautiful in the world, and that final chord will be a sound of praise. This is what we ask you to do, sing a new song and an order.
Token and pledge of my constant love and abiding faith, with this ring I thee wed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
As a token of my pledge and of our constant faith and abiding love, with this ring I thee wed in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.